Hi, everybody. So the objective of the webinar is to present you and to share our experiences regarding the IoT project. What is the main step, and also what is the issue you can have regarding the development of your own IoT device, IoT solution. And the objective for us is to capitalize on our expertise and experiences and share this experience in order to avoid you to making all the mistakes that we used to see in the project we are managing or in the project we are saving. So first of all, this is your IoT project. All the steps, the different steps you will have to manage in order to develop your solution. The first one is the business value, the technical assessments, the POCs, the prototyping is the second steps. After that, you will have to write the specification for your device, the objective you have regarding the solution, the global and the end-to-end solutions. And you will have to find a partner, design the device, certify it, and to work on an industrialization part and the production of your solution and device. We are focusing on the device because it's the main issue our customers and partners have generally. We are developing platform since 20 years now, potentially. This is not the problem. If you are miss your platform and you are doing mistake with the partner or the development, you can develop a new one from scratch and have some functional platform in a couple of months now using existing frameworks. But when you are missing your device, potentially you have invested a lot. And it's quite complicated to update the device and especially the firmware, the antenna, and so on. So that is why it's also the main investment you will have regarding your solution, the device itself, the NRE attached to the device. And our objective today is to share what is the main point you have to focus on each part. So we will start with the business value. It's generally something that the customer will not invest enough time in these parts. The objective for the customer is to have the capability to detect if he can go further and start the project. This is the evaluation of your business opportunity and the capability to generate value and generate money, services, enrich your portfolio. And this is very important to have a clear vision of what you want to develop and why you are developing this solution. So first of all, the first objective is to identify which kind of opportunity you want to develop. There is actually three reasons to develop an IoT devices and solution. The first one is to reduce your cost, your operational cost, by providing a solution that can collect information and data. The data collected by the IoT, it's very important, but the objective is to integrate this data in your process in order to make the decision at the right time and to optimize all the flow and the process you can have internally in your company. So some of the projects we are developing actually are focused on the cost optimization and the reduction of the current operational and environmental costs. The second one is you have an amazing ideas and you want to enrich your portfolio of service with the new services and new products. This is a new revenue, this is generated new solution. This is easily you can easily analyze the add value for your revenue when you are developing the solution, but it's important to evaluate also the cost associated to this solution. And for that, we will then provide you some key points during the presentation.
Voici quelques filtres.
And the last one, it's objective to have a better understanding regarding your customers. What is the customer experience? How I can improve this customer journey? How I can collect information in order to extend my services and be proactive regarding the customer requirements and customer needs. And this is important to use the IoT device as a part of your customer services in order to be different and to compete with your challengers and the other markets. By identifying the pain point of your customer, by optimizing the customer journey, by providing a differentiated approach regarding the customer experience. Most of times, customers are asking about what kind of data I can collect. At these parts, they're thinking about how I can collect this data. But the objective for us is just to focus on the value generated by the data and which data you have to collect, not how, because the how is provided by the technology. And at this stage, the objective is not to select and focus on the technology, but to focus on the value and the services you want to generate. And this is also important to integrate this data into a global lake of data. The IoT is just a part of the data you are collected every day. You have the customer profile, you have a lot of various data, your employees' journey, you have potentially an historic of your ordering and so on. And for that, the objective of the IoT is generally to integrate this data in order to make a decision or to provide the services. But this data will be integrated and correlated with data coming from other applications and potentially other point of collection. So this is important for your decision. It's to identify what are the missing data I have to collect in order to complete all the existing data and to evaluate a service in association with all these information. Many times, our customers and partners forget to integrate the customers in the reflection because the customer and the user is potentially different depending on the use case. But the users, you have to know that the user and the customers is your targets. And your objective is to respond to the pain point and to the customer objectives. So your driver have to be the customer experience and the customer expectation. So your project will be led by the customer satisfaction, will be led by the interest of the customer about your solution and your devices and services. So this is very important to integrate them into the reflection and iterate around their pain points, their expectation, their life cycles or their journey with the interest to capitalize on their needs and to feed your specification and your services specification. It's also important to challenge your ID. The first ID is generally not the best one. And especially when you have put in front of your user and customers, the first thing they say, no, no, that's not happened like that. This is not what I am expecting. You are thinking about that, but the real life is this, this, and that. And it's very important to focus on the services you want to deliver and the add value you want to deliver on the customers, and not to forget that this initial ID could be potentially not the good one and could be challenged also by the cost, because potentially the ID is very smart, but the market is not ready to get the solution at the price you are expected, or that makes your business model fly, or regarding the complexity, because you have also to integrate the fact that you have to install potentially the solution, and when you are installed, that generated costs, and potentially that also have an impact regarding the business model, but also regarding the operational costs and the SLA you can have regarding your services and solution. And for that, it is very important to evaluate all these criteria and stress test your idea, integrating all the feedback you can have from your customers, from your sales teams, because potentially they are in front of your customers and they are knowledgeable regarding the customer pain point and so on, and potentially the capability to market and to define the commercial value for your company within the device and services. And this is important to keep that in mind in order to evaluate the viability and the economical equation of your solution. And the last one is generally the most difficult to take, is you have to take a decision. Do not hesitate to postpone your decision. Do not hesitate to renounce to an idea. Do not hesitate to go further if you are trusted and you are confident regarding the capability to generate value and money on this solution. But it's very important to have a clear vision and clear understanding about the consequences to go further, and to invest your time and your energy on your project if you decide to continue and to start the solution. The next one is regarding the technical assessments. Someone calls that POC, POT, POV, PO, prototype, call it what you want. But the objectives and the only things you have to keep in mind is your objective is to test potentially the solution, but to have a clear vision regarding the direction you want to move. Potentially, you can stop, as I said previously. All the steps is important to keep in focus that you can renounce at any times, even if you have invested a lot of money on your project. Because if you don't trust about the solution at the end, you will potentially lose more money than you have already invested on the solution. So this is important to keep that in mind. But the objective of the technical assessments is to have a vision in the direction you want to continue. And for that, it's very important to have some success criteria in order to evaluate and assess this technical part. The first one is at the beginning of your test, it's mandatory to have and defined all your acceptance criteria. What is your objective of your POC? What is the challenge you want to test and to try and to solve potentially. What are the technology you want to compare and so on? And also, what is the criteria and the comparison criteria if you are comparing some technology in order to have a fair decision at the end and not be managed by the potential affinity you can have with one technology or another. Keep in mind that all the technology has their pros and cons depending on your project. Potentially, the first project you will do will be a Sigfox one, the second one will be a GSM one, and so on. It's really depending on the use case, on your customer experiences, and for that, do not hesitate to challenge all the technology align with the product you want to develop. Another one is you are doing a test assessment. You are not testing the final product. It's not your objective is not to have the 100% of your features covered by this POC. Limit your POC expectation to the bare minimum of the features you want to assess and to evaluate. Too complex is the POC. More complex will be the decision making at the end because it will be complex and difficult for you to evaluate these criteria and also to evaluate the capability to continue your project. Another one is not generally not interesting to develop from scratch a solution for your POC. There is some exception regarding that. It's really depending on the confidence you can have regarding the solution itself. And some customers are targeting directly at this stage a pre-serie approach with a device maker and device manufacturer. But most of time, you can assess your needs with a potential existing solution. That means, as I said previously, this solution will not cover all the features and the functionality you want to assess globally, but you can associate potentially several devices or solutions in order to complete the portfolio of features you want to evaluate. And in association with all this solution, potentially can evaluate the interest to continue and to validate a specific technology. Generally, the POC phase is one of the most complex for the customers because an IoT project, and you will see regarding all the references we have, generally the customers and the end customers we have is not their businesses to develop an IoT device and a hardware device. They are skills in various domains, but not in the electronics. For example, Louis Vuitton in the luxury stuff, Total in the oil and gas domain, and so on. And for them, the IoT, like the blockchain, like all the buzzword, but behind there is a technology and also a complexity associated to this technology. The project management and the project manager behind is key in order to drive the business expectation, and because the objective of the technical assessment is to evaluate the technology in front of a business or a business solution. When I say that, the objective is to evaluate if the technology will respond to the business strategy of the solution. And what we have seen generally, if when there is a lack of project management from the customer side that will impact the capability also to the customer to project on the next phase. Because when you are collecting data, that means also you will have to process it, you will have to evaluate the value of all this data. This is something new because you potentially it's your first IoT project. And for that, you will have also to integrate all this data inside your data lake or inside your platforms in order to compare the data and to evaluate the value of this data and the low relevancy of this data. And for that, the project manager will be the maestro of the solution in order to pilot the IT of the customers, to pilot the device maker or the solution or the subcontractor who was performing the POC and so on. And as I said previously, sometimes it will be interesting to skip the POC. And if you are confident regarding the technology and your capability to develop and start a product based on the business assessment you have done previously, that could be interesting regarding the cost saving to move directly to the pre-series and to start working with the device manufacturer in order to develop and assess a solution close to the final one. But it is in a very specific case, and actually in all the projects we have developed, we have started just three projects, the pre-series project, and we have managed more than 100. So specification writing is very important because generally only if you are techies and you have all the skills regarding the device development that includes the embedded softwares, the antenna, the casing, the certification parts, and so on. We will see in details just after. But it's very important to specify your needs and also to integrate that. An IoT project involves a lot of stakeholders and different skills. So when I say that, I said previously, a device is composed of an antenna, so that required an antenna designer, antenna engineers, a casing, so that need a robotics or 3D designer also in order to identify and to design the casing of your solution, embedded softwares, platforms, mobile application, and so on. So all these skills don't choose to work all together. And the important during the specification writings is not to focus on what they have to do, but how they have to do your solution, but what they have to do. When I say that, the objective for them, for you, is to describe your expectation, your goals, the solution, not to focus on the how they will provide and respond to these requirements, but focus on the main points you want to achieve. And when you will have focus on that, after they will integrate all this input in their process and provide you some documentation in order to evaluate if this requirement are matching with the solution and so on. Another point very important is the identification one. Identification of a partner. We have a huge ecosystem. We have a lot of partners developing devices and so on. And for that, there is three things to avoid. The first one is to select a partner you used to work with, but not skilled in the domain you are addressing. For example, the IoT, you have working with an IT integrators. IoT is hardware. It's quite complicated for an IT integrator to develop a new business unit and just develop your device. So it's important to select the good one who has already references and experiences in the domain you want to develop. For example, if you have to develop an asset tracking device using GPS, the GPS integration is quite complex sometimes. So it's important to have a partner and to select one where they have already experiences and they have already developed a solution using these technologies. Another one is potentially something you can say, okay, it's normal, but it's very important to select a partner who is passionate as you are. Because in our experience, we have seen that when the partner don't trust on your solution, the final result will be not at the expectation level you have set. So this is important to have and to evaluate the passion of your partners and to evaluate that as a criteria for during the selection part. And as I said previously, it's never too late to turn around, even if you have selected the wrong partners. You can quit and you can stop your product and solution. Sometimes it will be smarter to stop a solution that reinvest on a new one or transfer to a second partners or second subcontractors the existing project where they will have to analyze all the history of the project and so on. It's quite complex, but you will have also to take some time bad decision for your projects, and do it's very important also to have in mind that the project can end before the commercial launch. The design, I will focus on one point regarding the device, and especially with the connected device. The first things to focus and to secure is the antenna, because the solution it's a communicating device, so he has to transfer data. The second one is the antenna, and the third one is the antenna. Most of times, when we have issue regarding the device, is due to the antenna, because antenna is quite complex. Everyone has already potentially work on a Raspberry or hardware device and so on, but the antenna capabilities is very, very specialized skills, and for that it's mandatory to evaluate in which context you will have in which context your device will be deployed and so on. An example, this is a button, for example. If you are developing a button you are using in your hand, a button you are using in the wood table, a button you are using in the fridge, a metal one, it's three different buttons. And the antenna must be adapted regarding where the device will be used. And depending on that, that could have a significant impact on the quality of the service you will have for your device and the global services and the customer feedbacks regarding the devices. And most of times, this information and this criteria has not been enough anticipated by the device makers, the designers, or the end customers. And most of times, they are contacting us in order to perform some antenna redesign and antenna update in order to improve the quality of the service. Because for us, we are deploying a network. We are not deploying a network just for your use case. And if the device is very bad, the first thing that the customer will say is the Sigfox network sucks. But at the end, it's your device, it's not working well. And if we have potentially a lack of coverage in a specific area, we can provide and add additional antenna. But if the device has a bad antenna design, it will be very complex for us to deploy and to multiply by 2, 3, or 4 the number of antenna to respond to your specification and your needs. And in this case, our objective is to have the best level of quality regarding the device and to complete and to cover the territories where we have coverage by adding new antenna, base station. But it will be harder for us if all the design has a bad design regarding the antennas. Certification is important. This is potentially one of your top priority. It's depending of the strategy you can have on the solution. For that, be aware that every commercial device must be certified. And potentially in any country you want to deploy your services. Sometimes, if you have an international or a global solution, that will require a multiple certification in all the country, one in Europe, one in US, one in China, one in South Africa, one in Mexico, and so on. And depending on that, you can have a certification strategy in order to optimize your cost and also reduce the delay of the solution. For example, some countries can have dependencies and can recognize certification of other countries. So sometimes it could be interesting to select your certification in order to limit the cost and the time for your global services. And another important one is when you fail certification, generally that adds a delay of several months, between 3 and 5 months, and that could have a significant impact on the commercial launch of your solution, because you will the certification is a mandatory step before the industrialization and the mass production of your solution. So that means your device will be not produced on time, but also potentially the production line will be not available more, will be no more available when you have passed all the certification, and you will have to wait a new slot for producing your device, adding some delay. Potentially the component you have selected will be no more available due to the market and the fact that other partners, other customers, other people in the ecosystem are developing also IoT device and are using the same components that you have listed in your device. And that could have other issues regarding your delay. If you are not anticipate all the criteria regarding the certification and integrate that at the beginning of your project and device development. The industrialization and the production Generally, customers say yes, I have finished a project, but it's not generally the case. And to be honest, it's just the beginning, because that means you will start to produce your device, and at the end, that means you will start to be able to commercialize your solution, so you will have to manage additional stuff. Some interesting points regarding the device manufacturer you can have, and we can share, is be transparent regarding your volume forecast. A device manufacturer, an EMS, potentially can reduce this device cost if you are able to secure and to convince him that he will have a recurring volume to produce, and this information for them, an EMS is more interesting to have ten units to produce per year until just one time to produce 100 units, because like that he can secure a production line. He will have recurrent revenues. He will be able also to manage with distributors the component purchasing by providing also this forecasting and to aggregate all the forecasts of all their projects in order to reduce and to have the more ways to challenge the distributor costs. So it is very, very important to be transparent with them, not overestimate, but not underestimate also this volume. Share what you can share, but that could help you to reduce the cost of your production cost and the industry in the and the unit cost. You will have to also invest times on the quality test, because you know your solution, you have specified it, and it's important also you to invest times on the quality tests you want to perform at the end of the production line. You will have to provide the tests you want to perform to the device makers or the EMS, and for that it's important to have a clear vision of what the EMS can test during the production line. What is the test you want to perform in order to guarantee the same level of quality for your device, and share this information with the device maker and be involved during the test specification. Not let just the EMS or the device maker manage that. You have your word to say in the test you want to perform, so have your voice on this point. Another point is the production strategy. It's important for you to identify that if you want to produce 100 units or 200 units, potentially you will be able to manage and to challenge the cost, because the cost is an association of the number of device you want to produce, the complexity of the device, and so on. And sometimes it could be interesting to invest potentially more at the beginning of the project in order to reduce the global cost of your device and identify potentially a cost saving in your production strategy. Or if you have a lot of points you cannot project regarding the volume, not overestimate that and be safe regarding the production. Potentially you will pay more your device, but at the end, if there is some question mark regarding your volumes and your market you can address, limit the production for the first batch, and potentially you can manage and challenge the second batch in order to have the same price for the both. Another point, the production is the point where you will engage the most of your funds to produce a device that costs. It's also depending on the volume. So be prepared that the industrialization and the production will generate cash flow between you and your partners, and anticipate that. Another point is generally the costs are not including the shipping and the custom costs. Integrate that the fact that depending on the country you want to target and where you want to commercialize your product, you will have also to integrate that in your cost. And the customs could also require some documentation in order to allow the shipping and to transfer that. And the last point is the customer services. You will have potentially a commercial product you will sell to your customers. And it's important also to integrate the customer satisfaction and also to be able to respond to the customers when they have an issue with your solution, when they have an issue with the installation of your devices, when they have an issue with the connectivity and the and so on. And be aware that the typical warranty you will have regarding your device, it's 2 years guarantee. So do not hesitate also to use this warranty when the device is not responding to all the quality criteria you have set with your partners. And it is more important to be invest in the quality test in order to verify and to guarantee that all the device you have received are compliant with your expectation. The last one is the production launch. You are now able to sell and generate revenue. So the only recommendation I can say is do not hesitate to contact us if you have any question or any issues with your IoT project. It could be from the beginning or a specific part, the partner identification, the antenna design, the specification, and so on. We will be pleased to support and to help you in all this specific phase of your project. And this is some references we can have, actually. We cannot communicate on all of them because some are still confidential, but most of the biggest projects of Sigfox you have seen in the newspaper is a project managed by the IoT agency in the end. Thank you, everyone, for your for listening me during this webinar. And now I will be pleased to respond to all your questions you can have.
So thanks, Florian. So I will now take questions, and I will start by the one asked firstly in the question. So please, if you have new questions, please ask them in the question section on the right of your app. The first question, which I understand, is a question from Marco Olacua, who was asking about the point of antenna. Can you give more details about maybe more details about antenna design and in which it can impact your whole design, etc., just in 1 or 2 minutes?
Yes, for sure. The antenna is the important phase when you are developing your devices, and especially the antenna, is to identify how the device will be used. It will be used in the end, so you are composed about 60% of water, so that can have an impact on the radio wave and so on. So the design must be adapted and configure in order to work in this configuration and specific environment. Another one is if your device must be stick on the metal wall, potentially also the antenna must be adapt on this part in order to be the most efficient as possible. The important phase is it's very important for you to keep in mind that the antenna design is a dedicated task for your device. It must be reflect at the beginning of your solution, because as I said previously, the antenna design will be depending on how you will use the device and in which context it will be used. So do not hesitate to integrate antenna designer or antenna manufacturer in your reflection in order to collect information on the viability and the capability to use this kind of antenna is in this context. Another point is also to challenge the use case in order to potentially evolve your antenna design to adapt your solution in the better antenna context. What I mean is, in fact, sometimes you want to have the device in your hands and potentially, or stick in your foot, potentially they will have a better place to install your device, and you can have a reflection in order to reduce the antenna impact on your devices.
So okay, thanks Florian for that. And I think what if you have a project with regarding hardware, ask an antenna guy before to do anything. He will be the one to actually tell you what to do. So the next question was about certification. You mentioned project which required a lot of certification, and the question that Argenis Perez had was, does this certification is regarding to local government certification or Sigfox certification?
It's all of that. In fact, every Sigfox device must be certified by Sigfox. The objective for Sigfox is to verify that the device is compliant with all the criteria we have set regarding our technology. And when we talk about commercial certification, we are talking about what we call the type approval certification. For example, it's the CE in Europe, the FCC in US, and generally this certification is a governmental certification, potentially aggregated between some countries. It's the case in Europe, all the European countries are recognizing the same certification. But there is sometimes other certification, like the ATEX certification, the IP certification, the protection index, the index of protection regarding the water resistance, the shock resistance, and so on. And depending on the solution you want to develop, potentially you will have to pass various certification. And a case actually for a customer project, we are passing the ATEX one. It's to be it's a certification for device where we'll be close to the explosive product, like the gas, like the oil, and so on. And this provides some constraints regarding the devices and must be anticipated at the beginning of the project.
So thanks, Florian, again. Just for you to know, we have a lot of questions, like a lot, so we'll not be able to do all of them. Please, if you if you want to ask them directly to us, come on the community that we have online, and we will gladly answer them. So if you don't know what our community is, please go on build.sigfox.com or ask question directly to Florian at iotagency@sigfox.com. we'll answer them. So if we don't answer it today, please send an email to iotagency@sigfox.com. Florian will do his best to actually answer them. The next question we had was actually, could you... I lost the question I wanted to ask. So the next question was, can you share the success case of any agency IoT customers? Can you say a bit more about all these logos, maybe for one?
Yes, some of them have already communicated on the press, so you can direct Google hold these references and add Sigfox in the Google tab. The first one is the Louis Vuitton device. It's a luggage tracker for Louis Vuitton suitcase. The objective for the Louis Vuitton is to provide an additional services to each customers, because when they are flying, the main risk for the Louis Vuitton suitcase is to be stolen. And for that, they want to provide an integrated tracker inside the suitcase in order to track and to provide the geolocation information to the end customers and end user, in order to secure and provide feedbacks to them regarding their luggage, and also at the end, everybody potentially have the same behavior when they are in front of the carousel belt in the airport, saying my luggage is there or not with this device. When the aircraft is landing, they will receive a notification saying where is the device, and at the end you will know if the device is in the same airport or not.
So thanks for sharing that. Again, if you have questions about the other ones, I saw a lot of questions about Veolia, all of these brands that you were asking. Please send directly a contact to Florian on this email. He'll be able to answer you directly. So the next question that we had was from Pedro Figueroa, and the question was, according to your experience, what will be the right MVP stage in this model? What is the best MVP stage in the model?
Just to be clear, when you are talking about MVP, the minimal valuable product, in these models, it's quite complex, this question, because there is not just one answer for that. The MVP, as we are developing that for platforms, is the minimum product that generates enough information for your services. And what we see generally with the customers, I'm not sure to respond to the question, but I would share our experiences regarding that, is the customer are generally adding too much functionality and make the solution too complex regarding the real needs and the initial expectation of the final users. So when you are specifying your solution, keep in mind if each features and functionality are relevant, and what is the value and the revenue generated by each features, in order to select if the cost, because a feature adding a sensor, the functionality that could have a cost on the of the device itself, but also on the battery consumption. So potentially the lifetime of your device will be impacted by adding by these features. So have in mind all the value generated by each features, and compete this feature with the cost generated and the impact you will have on your services.
Okay, so thanks for that. So it's more, we have one question, which is actually not a question, but maybe a comment. We have one comment saying that they would love to be able to see more more case study about, you know, like how you take like a customer from the beginning into the end, and having that online. So this is a request that we have from the participants saying that the thing that you said, having kind of a white paper study of one customer from A to Z, I guess would be useful. So thanks for asking this question.
And potentially that could potentially deserve a new webinar next year dedicated on some case studies in order to share concretely these experiences in a concrete case.
So thanks. So maybe the last question that, and I'm very, very sorry. I saw questions about the Sigfox bubble. I saw questions about, you know, like some stuff. Please, sorry, but send an email to Florian. He will do his best again to answer. And yeah, we don't have the time to dwell on them. So the last question that we can take is actually, Florian, do you have a checklist in order to define the acceptance criteria?
Yes, indeed. It's very important to, if at the end, effectively, to define all these criteria, especially with the EMS, in order to validate that. And that is why it's very important to be integrated also into the definition of tests you will have, because the exception criteria will be also based on the test performed by the device makers. If this question, potentially you can send directly an email, and we will share what we have and what we can on this topic. But it's quite complex, it's quite complicated sometimes, sometimes not, depending on the use case. But it could be interesting to share directly in one-to-one this point.
So thanks, Florian. I think we'll actually stop it here. It was really, really great to have all these feedbacks. And thanks for attending. You will receive a new email saying for the next one, etc. You know, again, feel free to come on our communities online, etc. And reach us. We're very easily available. So please feel free to do so. And yeah, so I will give you a meeting for the next one next year. And have a good night. Everybody who asked a question actually got an answer regarding, you know, for the next, if they want to be answered. So again, if you have a question, you didn't get an answer today, you know, send an email to Florian and you should have received an email for that. And yeah, so thanks again. Have a good night. Thanks, Florian. And see you next time.
Thank you.